Okay, so we're doing two do-it-yourself recipes today, and we're using Purify, which is the cleansing blend essential oil from doTERRA. And the first one is a stove scrub. So if you have any type of stove, this is an amazing, non-toxic, super, super easy scrub to clear your stove. Now, my stove isn't horrible, but I thought I would show you anyway what it's like to make this scrub. Okay, so all you're taking is a quarter cup of baking soda. Okay. Then we're going to do a quarter cup of salt. Use whatever salt you have. I just use table salt for this recipe. It's cheap and easy. Then a tablespoon of apple cider vinegar. I use a great big one because I drink this as well, but you can use a regular bottle without the mother. That's fine if you know what I'm talking about. And a couple tablespoons of water. So it's going to make like a thick paste. There we go. And then you only need maybe 4 to 5 drops of Purify. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then you can just mix it up. I'm just gonna use my finger because it's easier and faster. So you can take a good look at what that's like. Kind of foamy, oozy. Okay, so once it's well mixed, you can take it however you'd like. I use my hands. I'm pretty hands-on in my house, but I'll use more if I need it, but I'm just gonna put it on the areas that I really need extra scrub, so where things are stuck. You can see me put it in there. And I'm gonna leave this sitting on my stove. So it's gonna sit on my stove for about 15 minutes, and then I'm going to wipe it away, and then I'll give it a good couple washes over with just some water and a cloth. And you can just use a sponge to be able to scrub this after, but first I wanna get it in all the areas that things are stuck, and I'll leave it there. My back of my stove isn't too bad, so I'll just give a quick rub over with my hands. It smells good, I have to say. It just makes the whole kitchen smell better. Purify is so good at getting rid of other scents, other odors that you don't want around. So I'm just gonna leave that on the stove, that's it. And then the rest of this, you can put a lid on and store, okay? So that makes it super easy to store it for next time. And you probably will get, I would say, probably 6 to 8 applications. If you have a super dirty stove, maybe 4. Okay, so let's move on to the next one. So this one is, these are fridge, and again, I call them fridge tablets, but the reality is they're just deodorizers. So you can use these in your fridge to deodorize. They'll last for about a month in there, and you can just swap them out. Any extras you make, again, just store in an airtight container and then pull them out for the next use and throw out the old one. Or you can use it in your bathroom, just put it in a little container, leave it open to help refresh the air. You can throw it in the bottom of garbage cans, you can put it in your carburetor, so whatever it is that you just want to reduce stink in those areas. Your front hall closet maybe, where shoes are, just put it in a little container, so I'll show you what you do. So again, we're going to work with a bit of baking soda. I'm going to use about a half cup in this. So I'm making a small recipe. You could do this like in a 2-cup recipe, and that way you can make lots at a time and store them. I'm gonna use about a half a cup. Should I do a whole cup? Maybe I'll do half a cup. You know what, let's do a whole cup. Why not? I could use a few extra right now. So we'll make a whole cup. There we go. And then all you're gonna add is enough water to make it very thick. So I guess we could measure just to show you an idea of about how much, but you're using about, not quite half, of whatever the amount of baking soda used. And this one, excuse me just for 1 second, you can take a look at that. This one I'm gonna use a spoon to stir it up, only because I wanna figure out if it's thick enough. So if it's really thick like this, it gets too thick and there's still lots of dry, you're just gonna add a little bit more. Okay, so just add to it until it's like a super thick paste, but a paste that would hold together once it dries out, not crumble apart too quick. Okay, so that's probably about where it's going to be. So you can get a feel for about how thick that is, that it's kind of balling up. It's about what you would want, like, for making a good sandcastle. And then in this one, I'm actually going to put more Purify because I'm using this specifically, right, to get rid of odor. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. I'm gonna use 15 drops And I would probably, again, you can use, you can see what works for you, but anywhere between 8 and 15 drops to add of the Purify. And then all I do, use any type of silicone mold. So you might have a whole bunch of silicone molds that are attached, that's fine. I just have my cupcake molds, and these ones I use to make bath bombs and little party soaps. So I just pack it in tight, tight, tight. You can make it as big or small, even you could even do a half size of this. Now these will take, in this size, will take about 2 to 3 days to dry completely. So they'll look a little bit wetter on the top right now, and that's fine. But like I said, in 2 or 3 days, they'll be hard as a rock. And that's what I will end up using then in my bathroom or in my fridge or wherever you'd like. And again, you can make these smaller. You can put a little less Purify if you find this is stronger than you need. But I find that this lasts like good purifying odor power for about a month. So that's pretty good. I'm happy with that amount of Purify that way. So there you go. So I'm making 3. And those will dry out in a couple of days. And I've got them good to go, see? And pennies, right? Pennies to make these recipes. And so now all I'm gonna do is, let's just move back over to the stove. I'm gonna move these out of the way. I'll set them out of the way to dry. I'm just gonna go back to my stove. I'm gonna just do a quick wipe through with a sponge and give it a good scrub on those spots that were hard to get through. Oh, those are all gone. So everything that was here is gone around this rim. And then I think this one that's a little bit more caked on over here, it might need a little longer because it hasn't been 15 minutes, but oh, I don't know. No, it's all coming off. So there you go. It wasn't even 15 minutes, but I'll just clear it all off like that first with my sponge, and I won't keep you here watching me scrub, but once it's off like that, then I'll go back and just collect it all, throw it out, and get some water and a clean cloth and wipe down my stove, and it'll be finished for the day. So there you go. 2 super easy, really super cheap recipes, non-toxic, which is huge, right? Because you're touching these things and you're in these things, and not only will it refresh the smell in the area, but it's just, it's okay. It's okay for your kids, for your animals to be around, and for you to be handling with your hands. Have a great day. Thanks for joining me.